get my little brown brush. I like to do little canvases once in a while. So, and this brush is very good for this, for when you want like a little bit of. Fun to me. Nice and mushy. Get kind of cloudy. I like it when it looks kind of cloudy, you know, when you punch it in and make it look cloudy, especially down the middle. Down the middle, away from the forest. Let's go. You see? It becomes really nice and cloudy back there. You know? But sometimes you like those to look kind of cloudy. Especially the forest. I don't want the forest to. It's okay. The ones that's drying, I could always process them. It's nice to kind of put it down there. I've always been inspired by Bob Ross and by my friend Peter Drennison. He's a very great artist, and for the past, you know, a few years, I've been watching him and learning from him. I say yes, he is. He's a good friend to have, you know. Friends like that will come once in a while. I don't worry too much about the bottom, but I don't know if you know I like mountains. It's like every weekend was beach time for all of us. My mother had 7 children, so guess what? So as you guys know, I'm going to be selling jewelry. I hope somebody will buy some jewelry and support me, support my channel, support my ambitions in life besides art. I've always liked jewelry. I always wore jewelry. It's a radio lighter brown. More like a burnt sienna brown. It's very like burnt. It was in a dark brown. Yeah, it's like a burnt sienna. This is a dark brown. It's like in the family of the Van Dyke brown. Let's see. Look, this is like mountains to look like mountains. You know, some people say, oh, you gotta do that straight across like a mountain. No, not all of them are really that straight across. You see some that have little difference to them. Actually, you know what? It's what you feel. However you feel at that moment, that's how you make it. And these are gonna look good because the white is gonna make them look good. I don't wanna put too much. No, I'm not doing clouds. I just wanna make it look like a foggy day in there, you know, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back in there later on and redo some more of the background here. Like for water, you know, and this is hard like a rock when you wet it. Yeah, I don't leave my when they're resin, no. He doesn't touch them. I think it's a little brown in some area because the brown went into it. But, talking to myself.
Oh, jeez.
Kayaku. My husband thought I was losing it. Like, who are you talking to? So, yeah, every time I'm near you, crazy. Later you'll see what I did to it on my next purchase with the store that I buy from, because I use sponges a lot. I like to use sponges to make it look kind of, you know, cloudy and very nice, like the London fog kind of white. Mm-hmm. You guys can see what I am doing. Yeah. Wonderful, it has arrived. I mean, the green made it look cute, but thank you, Peter, for teaching me that. But I like the green, the white better. Makes it look more like fog. The water. Too much about the edge, because when I go over the grass again, I will hit those edges really good. I'm not going to use any more yellow. I'm just going to leave it alone now. I'm going to let this do it. I'm going to put it up with some nuts. Mm-hmm. down here is a good idea. And another rock up here. Like that. I'm gonna shape those rocks differently. I'm gonna make them different because I don't like the way they look. So this one's gonna come a bit more closer to the to that tree there. And this rock could be a little bit more like that. And then eventually jumped in, of course, because I wasn't going to go to a big mountain and not get in the water. There's no way. No way that I would do that. And my mother would always check to see if there was any animals around, because she found out about the how you could ruin your kidney if you're in the water and there's animal feces in the water. You don't want to come back. Puerto Rico, whatever. You know, anywhere where there's a lot of waterfalls and rivers especially, you have to be careful that there's no animals along those areas. Because you could end up with a real bad sap green. It looks more like a viridian green to me. It may be. You know, like the my colors, I mean, after a while, since you don't work now, you go take it to the beach all day, hanging out. That gesso, all that gesso is gonna dry, and it's gonna be like a nice texture. It's gonna be a texture painting again. Yeah. I like to do, you know, like, I liked doing paintings that do a nice little scary tree. That's what's good about the brush. You could do anything with it. Yeah. And it makes your painting more beautiful. Yeah. It could be the water, it could be a little, like, you know, like green and brown across. Because everything look like a water, right? That's what I like. You make it look like that. And I'm talking to her. The next, you know, I'm whispering, and she's like, "An inch, why are you whispering? I'm right." Is this one thinner? Let's see. Oh, I'm putting my glasses. Funny, daddy. My glasses, you can see. Okay, let's see. That's like a little bit out that way. Not going down that way. On this one, I don't want to put too many branches. I want to let it kind of got a little that shape here. Water, how calm it is. Nice calm water by the mountains and the rocks. Little rocks in the bottom and the top next to the mountain. Love it. And the texture, look at the texture I did with the palette knife.